my version of, well, my version was pretty accurate, of Steve Gaines' solo on Working for MCA. He takes the first solo break. What can I tell you about the solo? It's a B pentatonic minor. The only difficult thing about it is that it's fast. It starts out, although the tonality doesn't sound like B major nor B minor to me, since the major chord is a B5 chord. It has no minor or major tonality. But the solo is in pentatonic minor. It starts out with the shape on... I can get a little more volume so I don't have to play over the music now, or trying to play under the music. So we have the B minor pentatonic starting on the fifth string. However, since we're so close to the nut, hopefully you're getting that. Since we're so close to the nut, only a whole step away, he makes use of the open strings. So the new, I guess we could say new position would be starting on the B note. We're going to make use of the open strings. So if before it was 1-4-1-3-1-3-2-4. 1-4 and up there. It's now going to be 1-open-1-3-1-open-3-2-open-1-4. It took me a lot. To get that. It's a little confusing. Sometimes you make use of the open string, sometimes you don't. Anyway, that's where it starts. Then it goes into the pillar that we all are familiar with, up in the B minor, up on the, what's that, the 7th fret. Then he goes into the Albert King box. Then we slide up to the next one. And then we slide back up to where we started, just an octave higher. That, I don't know, what's that, the fourth position maybe? Third position. So we start, we come right back to that, only an octave higher. Alright, let's start it. I have tab included, so maybe this is just for phrasing and follow along. A unison bend to start it. And I'm not sure about this, I just had to make some time. It sounds, maybe you might do this. I did it like that. Then this note, don't sound that note. So there's the open string. That's the phrasing on that. Here, it's very hard to hear, but he does this in that smell, and I have every reason to believe that's what he's doing here, although it's very hard to tell exactly. But he's starting. So he's still in that minor pentatonic box, if you will, and he's... hardest part about this phrasing, well, it's a little awkward, but when you're on that note, then you have to quickly jump back to that note in order to get the next phrase. So You can a lot of times sound like this, which is not the sound we're going for. In fact, you might want to be finger that note. What is that note? A B. Finger the B with your middle finger, and that frees your ring finger B up for the next one. It that way, it does stop from that hammer-on because you're missing the timing. Steve's timing is just impeccable. He just doesn't seem to miss a note. Then to go up from that one, it's not that note is sounded incidentally. That's really fast. I didn't do it up to speed. Not sure I did that right. Then we slide up to, so we're in the Albert King box here. Let me do it. I just feel the need to get. A three-step bend here. Pull off your finger. And the first time he does it through, he pulls off that note. Now he doesn't pull this off this one, he just hits that one. So a ghost bend. Almost, it's just a... So the trickiest part about this part is the what to do with right after that note. So all of them are the same. Holding that bend. The first two times we hold it. And the second time. Just a nifty little quick little pull off. And the third time, we release the bend and go up and down. You can staccato those notes if you can. I try to go down, move my thumb down on the pick so I can... Let me know what you think, if anything's not clear. I think I covered everything that I wanted to. I got a 70s flannel shirt on today, so I'm in the mood. I'm going to do the second solo, which is Gary and Alan together, and then I'll do something else. I'll try to get something else today. All right, thanks for watching.